स्टूडेंट्स, इन दिस लेक्चर वी आर गोइंग टू डिस्कस अ ड्रग दैट इज सल्फा सालाजीन, दैट इज बेसिकली अ सल्फोनामाइड. सो वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस द मोड ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द सल्फोनामाइड्स एंड द डेफिनेटली द मोड ऑफ एक्शन ऑफ द सल्फा सालाजीन इज सेम एज दैट ऑफ द सल्फोनामाइड्स. दैट इज, दिस इज द ड्रग दैट विल इनहिबिट द टीरियोएट सिंथेटेज एंजाइम. एज अ रिजल्ट देर विल बी नो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द डाइहाइड्रोफोलिक एसिड एंड एज अ रिजल्ट देर विल बी नो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ द डीएनए और यू कैन से नो फॉर्मेशन ऑफ प्यूरिन्स और पिरिमिडिन्स. नाउ सल्फोनामाइड्स that are, for example, we are going to talk about this sulfa salazine. Its absorption is very good because this absorption factor is actually its beneficial effector for its therapeutic effect. Most of the sulfonamides are absorbed well, except one drug, and this drug is the sulfa salazine. Sulfa salazine is the exception. That is the drug that is not absorbed well. So it is the drug that will remain in your intestine. So if it is in the intestine that it is not getting absorbed in your bloodstream, then it means this is a drug that can be used for your intestinal infections. This is the drug that can be used for the treatment of the chronic inflammatory bowel disease. For example, ulcerative colitis. Chronic inflammatory bowel disease itself contain different subclasses. Among them here, the mentioned one is the ulcerative colitis. So you can say this sulfasalazine is the drug that cannot be absorbed well, that is not absorbed when you give it orally or as suppository. Now what this drug will do, what your intestinal flora or the bacteria will do with that drug. Your local intestinal flora or the bacteria will split or convert the drug into two different categories, two different components, sulfapyridine and the 5-aminosalicylate. Now this 5-aminosalicylate is basically a metabolite which is good, which is responsible for the anti-inflammatory effect. Because of this, this can be used for the mentioned disease, that is the ulcerative colitis. Now the second component is this sulfapyridine. This sulfapyridine is actually not the required component. When this is absorbed in your bloodstream, this will lead to toxicity. When this will lead to toxicity, it will lead to toxicity in the patients who are the slow acetylators. So this toxic effect is not for the patients who are the fast acetylators. So this was all about the sulfasalazine.